Now we have studied till now we have studied the shortest job first algorithm, we have studied the longest job first algorithm, and we have studied the priority based algorithm. See, in case of round robin algorithm, there is no starvation because it is guaranteed that after some time every process will get the CPU. But in case of shortest job first, longest job first, and the priority based algorithm, it may happen that some process may starve. Starve means it is not going to get the CPU. For example, in case of shortest job first, if there's a big process which is waiting for the CPU, but again all the processes which are coming, they're having a shortest burst time, so the big process will not get the CPU for a very long time, right? So until the processes are coming and so on. In the same way, in the longest job first, if there's a shorter process, it is waiting for the CPU, it will not get the CPU if all the processes which are coming, they are very long. And in case of priority based algorithm, a lower priority process will wait until, because the other processes which are coming, they are having higher priority, so it will not get the CPU. So in case of round robin scheduling algorithm, it is guaranteed that every process will get the CPU. But when we discuss about the highest response ratio next algorithm, now this is a kind of algorithm which is designed to take the benefit of the shortest job first algorithm, as well as it is designed to remove the biggest problem with the shortest job first algorithm, that is the starvation process, right? So in this case, you can see the highest response ratio next algorithm prefers or favors the shorter jobs, and it limits the waiting time of the longer jobs. So here there is something called as, we are going to calculate a formula which is called as a response ratio, and response ratio is waiting time plus service time, or say service time, or can say burst time, divided by burst time of that process, that is the waiting time of that process plus burst time of that process divided by the burst time of that process. And this is how we are going to evaluate the response ratio, and we'll execute the process which is having the highest response ratio out of all the processes which are available. Let me show it to you with an example. Here there are 5 processes, P1, P2, P3, P4 and P5. These are the arrival times and these are the burst times. At time 0, there's only one process which is available, that is the process P1. So no other process is available. So we are going to execute the process P1 at time 0. And remember, this highest response ratio next algorithm only works in a non-preemptive fashion. That means we are not going to have preemptions. Okay, so we are going to execute the process P1 to time 0 to time 3. Right? After time 3, the process P2 arrived, and we don't have any other choice apart from executing the process P2 because there are no other processes which are available as of now. So we are going to execute the process P2, and its burst time is 6, so P2 will be executing till time 9. Now you can see till time 9 all the other processes arrived, that is the process P3, P4 and P5. Now we have to make a choice that if there are multiple processes which are available, then out of these processes, which process should we execute? Okay, for that purposes, we are going to calculate something called as response ratio. So response ratio, which I am going to denote it by RR. So response ratio for the process 3, P3, is waiting time plus burst time upon me, burst time. So waiting process time for process P3 will now be, currently the time is 9. The process P3 arrived at 4. So waiting time for process P3 will be 9 minus 4. That is 9 minus 4, this is the waiting time, plus the burst time of the process P3 is 4 divided by 4. So it will be 9 minus 4 is 5, it is 5 plus 4 divided by 4, which is 9 divided by 4, which is 2 point something. Okay, so you can evaluate as 2.25. Okay, now calculate the response ratio for process P1, response ratio for process P4. So in process P4, the process P4 arrived at time 6 and current time is 9. So just P4 has to wait for 9 minus 6, which is 3 units of time, plus the burst time of the process P4 is 5 plus 5 divided by 5. So it is 8 divided by 5, which is equal to 1.6, which is equal to 1.6. Now what is the response ratio for process P5? Response ratio for process P5. So process P5 arrived at time 8. So it is 9 minus 8 is 1. So 1 plus 2 divided by 2, which is 3 by 2, which is equal to 1.5. So out of these three processes, P3, P4 and P5, P3 is having the highest response ratio, and that is 2.25. That is the highest response ratio. So we are going to execute the process which is P3. Okay. and P3 is going to require the CPU for 4 units of time. So till 9 to 13 P3 will be executed, right? So now P3 is finished. Now we have two choices, that is P4 and P5. Out of these two, P4 and P5, again we have to evaluate the response ratio, and according to the response ratio we are going to give them the CPU, right? So again, the current time is 13. Again we have to evaluate the response ratio for P4, right? So P4 is arrived at time 6, current time is 13. So 13 minus 6 is the waiting time, plus the burst time of P4 is 5 divided by 5. So 13 minus 6 is 7 plus 5 divided by 5, which is 12 divided by 5, which is equal to 2.4. That is the response ratio for the process 4. Now evaluate the response ratio for process 5. So it is 13 minus 8, which is 5 plus 2 divided by 2, which is 7 divided by 2, which is equal to 3 point something. Right, so 3.5 something, right? So you can see the process P5 is having the highest response ratio. So we'll give the process P5, the CPU to the process P5. It will be finishing at time 15, and then we'll give the process CPU to process P4, and process P4 will be finishing at time 20. P4 will be finishing at time 20. So what is the completion time of process P4? Process P4 completed time 20. Process P5 completed time 15. Process P3 13, process P2 9, and process P1 3. So what is the turnaround time of each processes? That is completion time minus arrival time. So 3 minus 0 is 3, 9 minus 2 is 7, 13 minus 4 is 9, 20 minus 6 is 14, 15 minus 8 is 7, and waiting time is 3 minus 3 is 0, 7 minus 6 is 1, 9 minus 4 is 5, 14 minus 5 is 9, 7 minus 2 is 5. So in total it is 1 plus 5, 6, 6 plus 14, which is equal to 20. And total we have 5 processes, so 20 divided by 5, which is equal to 4 units of waiting time. So we will be having a waiting time which is equal to 4. Okay, so this is the highest response ratio next algorithm, where we'll execute a process which is having the highest response ratio every time. So we have to evaluate every time, we have to evaluate the high response ratio every time we have the processes. And we only evaluate it if we have more than one processes at the same time. So we have to make a scheduling decision accordingly. Okay.